How's everybody doing? Yeah. Feeling good at your 3:30 in the morning?
Yeah.
I'm not convinced.
Yes.
How are y'all feeling? As everybody knows, this is going to be a comedy hypnosis show. It is all volunteer-based. And I've got tons of volunteers already. Usually I don't ask for volunteers until we get started, but that's okay. Now, if you're sitting out in the audience and there's not enough room for you to come here and volunteer, don't worry about it. You can still follow along.
Lauren would volunteer.
You don't have to be up on stage to experience hypnosis. You can follow right along in that chair in your chair. Now, if you do decide to follow along, or you notice the person next to you deciding to follow along, and they go into hypnosis, don't wake them up, don't tap them, don't shake them. They're going to have much more fun tonight than you are. So just sit back and relax. Enjoy the next hour and a half. And we'll all have some fun together. So, by a show of hands, how many people have seen a hypnosis show in the past? Either live or on video? Not too many people already. Another show of hands, how many people have experienced hypnosis themselves?
Every single day.
You're absolutely right. So everybody experiences hypnosis every single day.
We just don't
call it that, right? So, how many of you guys drive? How many of you
drive?
Most of you? How many of you have ever driven someplace, either school or work, and you can't remember part of the drive? Right? You just kind of show up, and you wonder how you got there? How many of you have ever driven someplace, and you make a turn knowingly, you turn to go somewhere else? You think to yourself, why did I do that? I'm not going there. Right? So that's most of us. And then for everybody that decided that they didn't want to be honest, every time you go to sleep at night, just a couple minutes before you fall asleep, you experience hypnosis. So hypnosis is nothing more than a heightened state of subconscious relaxation and awareness. It's just like a dream state, almost. Are you guys ready to get started?
Yeah!
All right. So I'm going to turn the mic off for just a second, and I'm going to do a demonstration with everybody. And I do need everybody to be as quiet as possible once we get started here.
So for this demonstration, everybody can follow along on stage and in the audience. And we're just going to experience a little bit of what hypnosis is like, okay? So in just a moment, I'm going to have everybody extend your hands out like this. Don't do it yet. You might have to extend your hands out like this, and then clasp your hands together, lock your fingers, and push them tight together, right? Don't do it yet. In just a minute, I'm going to have you do it, okay? So, I apologize, you're going to be talking to my back. I don't want to talk to the rest of the audience. But you guys follow along. So on the count of three, I want everybody to take your hands like this, clap them together, clasp your fingers, interlace tight together. Don't do it yet. Do it on the count of three. All right, everybody ready? Hands up. One, two, three. Ready? On the count of three, clasp your hands together, okay? Do it. On three. One. Ready? Everybody ready? Sit still. Got some people still.
Hey, you're out. Right.
Ready? Sit down. This time for real. One, two, three. Interlock your fingers together. Now in just a moment, not yet, but in just a moment, I'm going to have you extend your index fingers up like this. Okay, don't do it yet.
Don't do it yet.
Have you extend your index fingers up like this with about an inch of separation in between. Some of you guys know what one inch looks like. And once your fingers are separated, I want you to stare at the space in between your fingers and only at the space in between your fingers. Watch closely, like this. Okay? Just stare at that space and only at that space, drawing everything else out. Once you start to stare at the space in between your fingers, I'm going to count from the number 10 down to the number 1. With each count and each snap of my fingers, your fingers are going to draw closer and closer together until the point where they touch. Once they touch, they get stuck tight. They will not come apart. Think, picture, imagine, visualize magnets on your fingers, pulling your fingers closer and closer together. Everybody, everybody on stage and in the audience, on the count of three, separate your fingers by about an inch and focus on that space between your fingers. One, two, three, fingers up, separated by about an inch, and concentrate. Think, picture, imagine your fingers drawing closer and closer together.
10, 9, closer and closer. 8, 7, 6, closer. 6, 5, 4, closer and closer. 4, 3, 2, 1, closer, closer, touching. If they're touching, they're stuck so tight that you can't pull them apart, no matter how hard you try. Try and find that you cannot separate your fingers. It's the wildest, craziest thing you've ever imagined in your life. And when I tap on the microphone, your hands and fingers go limp and relax. Allow that to happen now. How many people's fingers got stuck together? How many people's fingers are still stuck together? Good. All right, so we'll take the volume down just a little bit, and we're gonna play one more quick game. So everybody on stage, and everybody in the audience, make a gun. And then just follow by the make an okay. Make a gun. Make an okay. Make a gun. Make an okay. Gun. Okay. Gun. Okay. Look at mine. Look at yours. Look at mine. Look at yours. Look at mine. Look at yours. Look at mine. Now put it on your chin. Freeze! That's not your chin. Some of you went to your chin, but most of you went to your cheek. And that's okay. That's okay. Alright, so I already have my volunteers for this evening, and I appreciate your help, my volunteers. Let's give a hand for the volunteers up on stage. Now, just because you're not up on stage, you can still follow along in the audience. I ask that you do follow along if you really want to. Hypnosis is nothing more than the most relaxing thing you've ever felt in your entire life. Now, for the next 5 to 6 minutes, I'm going to ask that everybody be as quiet as they can. That will just allow for everybody to be able to hear the suggestions that I'm going to be able to give until I get everybody up on stage into the state that I need them. Now, I've got more people on stage than what I'm going to be able to safely use. So tonight, I'm looking for those people who go into a hypnotic state the fastest and the easiest. The only thing you need in order to go into hypnosis is to be able to follow instruction and follow direction. As long as you can do that, you're great. Now, if I ask you to go have a seat out in the audience, it doesn't mean that you can't be hypnotized. Some of the best volunteers, actually, are ones that I dismiss one night and they come back the next. So if I do ask you to go back out into the audience, just be polite. It's nothing against you. Tonight's just not your night. Okay? All right, so everybody get comfortable. And I'm going to step off to the side over here so everybody can stay a little bit. And just get as comfortable as you can. If you have glasses. If you have glasses, you may want to take them off just in case. I don't want to break your glasses unless you absolutely need them. If you're chewing gum, you got to get rid of that. Nobody on stage chewing gum? You tripped out over there? Crazy, isn't it? Alright, looks like we have everybody ready. So everybody on stage, let's take a deep breath in. And out. And relax. Everybody in the audience, let's keep quiet for about 5 to 6 minutes. Everybody on stage, deep breath in. and out. And if you're following along in the audience, everybody on stage and in the audience, deep breath in. Hold it. And as you exhale, allow your eyes to close. And just relax. So the first thing that we're going to do is focus on physical relaxation. We relax two ways, physically and mentally. So in order to relax physically, think, picture, imagine a chair or floor that you're sitting in. Imagine how good and comfortable it feels, how supportive it is, how you need not do anything but relax. Maybe direct your attention to your right hand and notice how good your hand feels. And direct that attention to your left foot, noticing how good your left foot feels. All you have to do is just relax and listen to the sound of my voice. Now in just a moment, I'm going to come up to some of you and check and see how physically relaxed you are. I'm going to do that by grabbing you on the hand. If I grab you on the hand, I know that you can help me if you want to, but don't help me. Just allow your arm to be loose, limp, and relaxed, just like a rag doll or a washcloth. You needn't do anything but relax. Just relax, just like that. Perfect. Relax, let it all go. Just a little bit more, not quite. Oh, there you go, relax. Good. Just relax. And let that wave of relaxation fall over your body. Perfect. Now you're all doing wonderful with physical relaxation. As I mentioned, we relax two ways, physically and mentally. So now it's time to work on that mental relaxation. In just a moment, I'm going to count number 100 down. And sometime before I reach the count of 95, you'll push all thoughts out of your mind. Make those numbers a burden that you can get rid of, a burden that you want to get rid of. By the time I reach the number 95 or sooner, pushing all thoughts from your mind and just letting go. 100, deeper and deeper relaxed. 98, just letting go, feeling tired and drowsy. 97, deeper and deeper relaxed. Today is past, tomorrow is 1,000 miles away. There's nothing more you want than to relax. There's nothing you need more than sleep. And you find that you can quickly and easily. 95. Now everybody on stage and everybody in the audience that's participating in just a moment, not yet, but in just a moment, I'm going to count to the number 3. And when I reach the number 3, you'll be seated upright, and you'll notice the camera in the middle of the room. Everybody focus on that camera in the middle of the room. Once you focus on that camera in the middle of the room, you'll hear me say 2 words. Those words are sleep now, and I'll snap my finger. Allow that to be your invitation to close your eyes and re-enter this relaxing state. Only you'll go twice as deep, feel twice as comfortable, and twice as relaxed. And at any time I should come up and touch you, you'll allow that relaxation to double. So you can feel twice as confident, twice as secure, and twice as relaxed. 1, 2, 3, eyes open, seated upright, take a look at that camera in the middle of the room. Eyes open upright, take a look at that camera in the middle of the room. And sleep now. loose, limp, and relax. Just let it all go. One, two, three, eyes open, focus on the camera in the middle of the room, focus on the camera in the middle of the room, and sleep now all the way down, loose, limp, and relaxed, feeling good, feeling wonderful. Everybody on stage, everybody in the audience, one, two, three, eyes open, focus on the camera in front of you, and sleep now all the way down, loose, limp, and relaxed, feeling wonderful in every single way. Now, it's going to get quiet for just a couple of minutes, and while it gets quiet, just allow that relaxation to double, feeling even better. Any sound that you hear around you just intensifies your relaxation. It allows you to relax even more. And allow that to begin to start happening now. Now, everybody on stage is doing fantastic, but as I mentioned, we do have too many people, so I will have to ask some people to come back into the audience. But before I do that, everybody on stage, picture, think, imagine, visualize the person sitting next to you is your pillow. You love your pillow. Your pillow is the most comfortable thing in the world. On the count of three, keeping your eyes closed, reach out and grab that pillow, fluff it up and get nice and comfortable. One, two, three, reach out and grab that pillow and get comfortable, get snuggly, fluff it up, there you go. And then just relax, feeling wonderful. Everybody feeling fantastic. There you go. That's right. And if you fall, that's okay. Just allow yourself to fall and relax. Only the person I'm touching right now, sit up for me. Only the person I'm touching now, sit up for me. And if I touch you, just everybody's doing fantastic. Doing so good. There's always a few. Always a few. Y'all want to see something crazy? Check this out. Hold my finger. Sleep. Everybody on stage, in just a moment, I'm going to have you sit upright, open your eyes just slightly, and if you're seated on the floor, find a seat. There's still not enough seats, but find a seat if you can. On the count of three, one, two, three, eyes open, sit up straight if you're on the floor, hop back up in your seat. If you're still on the floor, find a seat. Everybody's doing wonderful. Y'all can share, it's okay. Y'all can share. All right, so everybody's fantastic. It's really hard for me to pick, but if you don't have a seat, I'm gonna have you come back out into the audience. You can continue to play along. Let's give everybody a hand, right? Everybody give a hand. All right, so even if you're not on stage, if you're out in the audience, you can still play along. Everybody on stage and everybody in the audience who's playing along, sleep now all the way down, loose, limp, and relaxed. Feeling wonderful. How do you feel? Tired? Looks right here. Sleep all the way down your eyes. Crazy, right? Let me see your hand. I'm gonna give you something special, okay? I'm gonna give you something special in this hand right here. All you have to do is take your pointer finger and just touch right there on his forehead and tell him to sleep, and he'll be out. Crazy, isn't it? So again, my name is Jonathan. What's your name? Oh, what are you doing? There you go. Perfect. How do you feel? Kind of tired? And look at each other. Just look. And just focus. Sleep. Oh, my God. Hey, come on. You look a little glassy out of here, right? Only the person I'm touching right now. How do you feel? But now he's out in the audience for me. You can join them. And you too. Go out and join them. You're good. Just get comfortable. There you go. Get comfortable. Just like that. There you go. You look confused. All right, everybody, check this out. You look really confused. Doesn't she look confused? Doesn't she really know what's going on? Do me a favor. I want you to take your hand and put it right up in front of your face like this. And take your index finger and point at yourself. And as you're pointing at yourself, I want you to touch yourself on the forehead in a second. Touch yourself on the forehead in a second and say sleep to yourself. Go ahead and do that. Everybody on stage, from this point forward, all sounds that you hear are only going to serve as reinforcement to your subconscious mind. Everybody in the audience, let's give them a round of applause. Come here, Jordan. I got a comfortable seat for you, buddy. Come here. Stand up for me. I got a comfortable seat for you. All right, we're going to go right here. Have a seat right there. But as soon as you have a seat, take a look at me. As soon as you have a seat, push yourself back and get comfortable. As soon as you feel yourself get comfortable, all you have to do is think the word sleep. And you'll go to sleep and relax. Go ahead and do that for me. All right, let's give my volunteers a round of applause. Come on, be louder than that. All right, everybody on stage, on the count of three, you'll be seated upright, eyes open. Seated upright, eyes open. Every time I snap my fingers, it gets colder and colder. It's the coldest day you've ever experienced in your life. You'll do anything to keep warm. Snuggle up with the person next to you if you have to. Everybody on stage. One, two, three, eyes open, seated upright, and it starts to get colder and colder. It's now 40 degrees. 30 degrees. 20 degrees, colder and colder. 10 degrees, it's the coldest day you've ever felt in your life. 10 degrees, even colder. Colder and colder. Everybody enjoy it. And now, it's no longer cold. It's starting to warm up. It's back up to 40 degrees. And 50. And 60. Sun is shining, feeling wonderful. It's now 7 degrees. 80 degrees. I think somebody turned off the air conditioner. It's now 90 degrees, getting warmer and warmer. Up to 100. the hottest day you've ever felt. It's so hot, you'll do anything to cool off, except take off your clothes. It's now 110, scorching hot. Oh, it's so hot. 120. Yeah. Sleep now all the way down. Let's limp and relax. Everybody's doing the water as well. How do you feel? Just kind of weird. Yeah. Well, check this out. I have some stuff called sleep dust. I keep it in my pocket right here. Have you ever seen sleep dust before? I'm gonna hand it to you, but be careful, because if any of it gets on you, you instantly fall asleep, okay? So I'm gonna hand you, put a glove on that hand for me. Can you put a glove on? Let's put a glove on that hand so it doesn't touch you. Just hold the hand right there, okay? Now don't let any of this get on you. Right through the glove, there we go. How are you doing? Good? Only the person I'm touching right now, you can sit up on your own just a little bit, just slightly, right there, just like that. And sleep, relax all the way down. There you go. Get comfortable. Perfect. Now, everybody up on stage, on the count of three, eyes open. I'm going to do a little bit of rearranging here. One, two, three, eyes open. Eyes open. Set up right. Eyes open, set up right. What happened, Margo? You all right? Then have a seat in your chair for me. You good? Your hand goes to sleep on you? And pull that chair forward for me. Down here on the end, come with me. I'm going to have you sit right over here in the middle. Right there in the middle. And then you come down here with me. Have a seat right between those two young ladies right there. And you shift down two seats. Get nice and comfortable. Perfect. Everybody on stage, when I snap my fingers, you notice that the person sitting next to you smells like the worst thing you've ever smelled in your entire life. It smells like they haven't showered in a month. It's the worst thing you've ever smelled, and you can't stand it. Allow that to happen now. You're stuck to your seat and you can't move. It gets worse. And worse. And worse. Talk to a couple of you for here for just a second. Just kind of hold it if you can. Hold it if you can. Hold it in. How are you doing? You feeling okay? You're leaning, you alright? Can you describe what's going on right now? Does she smell bad? What does it smell like?
I don't know.
Come back to that. You look like you're suffering here, buddy. How are you doing?
Well, that was like hot milk with
dogs. That's pretty terrible. You ran away. You okay?
Cottage cheese.
You're just not even going to move your shirt, are you? No? We'll just let you sit there for just a few minutes. He's a star. We'll work with him. Jordan, man. How you feeling, buddy? I'm going to push this chair back. And I'm going to push this chair back. Stand up for me. I'm just going to right over here. Stand right there. Right there. Don't move. Eyes closed. Knees locked. Legs stuck. Sleep standing. Don't move. Sleep standing. Don't move. You can hold your own weight, support your own weight. Now, I'm only talking to you if I touch you on the shoulder. Any other thing that I say does not apply to you unless I'm touching you on the shoulder. Everybody on stage, you look like you're suffering with that smell. Let's make it the best thing you've ever smelled in your life. And it gets better. And better. And better. Get your nose in there. I really smell it. It's intoxicating. It smells wonderful. And it just keeps getting better. And better. And sleep now all the way down, listen and relax. Just feeling wonderful. Give them a round of applause. Round of applause. Only the person I'm touching right now, your hand is stuck to your head. It won't move. Everybody on stage, on the count of three, eyes open, be seated upright in your chair, safely. You have no idea what's going on. If you're on the floor, you don't know why. One, two, three, eyes open, feeling wonderful. Well, why are you down on the floor? Just, let's get your seats kind of rearranged here. I'm gonna have you stand up here for me. Stand up and kind of... There you go. Stand up for me. You okay? Oh, you hate your feet? Yeah, let me turn your chair. And stand up for me. And then pull your chair forward. Pull it all the way forward for me if you can. Yeah, I don't know that we can scoot very well here. Just go up, there we go, down. And now, have a seat and just relax and get comfortable. Now, everybody on stage, sleep now all the way down, loosen up and relax. Just like that. Now, everybody on stage, you don't believe in hypnosis. You think it's fake. You don't believe it's real. However, anytime I ask you what your name is, you have no idea what your name is. You can't tell me. Even if somebody tries to help you, you can't tell me what your name is. On the count of three, everybody on stage, eyes open, seated upright in your chair. One, two, three, eyes open. You all right, buddy? Fall down there on the ground. Slide down just a little bit. I think we're kind of sharing a chair there. You want to have your own seat? A little more comfortable. So, my name is Jonathan. What's your name?
I don't know.
Don't know. I've never known anybody. Don't know. How do you forget your name? What's your name? What's your name? We'll come back. And then you're right here. Do you believe hypnosis is real? No. Are you hypnotized right now?
No.
What's your name? We'll come back to it. I promise we will. How are y'all doing? Good? What's your name? Do you know her name?
Marie.
What's your name? No idea. Sleep now all the way down, just something relaxed, just like that. Let's give them a round of applause, everybody. Round of applause. Warmed up. So everybody on stage, we're about to take a trip to the movies. When you look out into the audience, there's nobody in the audience. All you see is the movie screen. And on that movie screen is the funniest movie you've ever seen in your entire life. And you're going to laugh hysterically, harder than you've ever laughed in your entire life before. On the count of three, eyes open, seated upright, and begin to watch the funniest movie you've ever seen. One, two, three. Seated upright, watching that movie. It's the funniest thing you've ever seen. And it just keeps getting funnier. And funnier. And funnier. And here comes the best part. It's actually a double feature. Two movies. The next one's getting ready to start. And it's a horror movie. It's a very scary horror movie. And it keeps getting scarier. And scarier. It's a romantic film. It's so sweet and romantic.
It's the only one that I can say that you're like, it looks so like
John. See, I have been like, put I'll get you. And now we're watching that romantic film and it keeps getting more romantic and more sweet and more sappy. It's the most romantic film you've ever seen in your life. And it just gets better and better. And they're so in love. Aww. And then right before the best part, the movie stopped. I guess the guy in the projection box messed up. Tell him what you think about it.
Oh, what the hell?
What are you doing?
All right, it's fixed. It's back on. It's running again. Sweet. It's so sappy. And now the movie turns into the saddest movie you've ever seen in your life. It's so sad. The doll ran away, and she's never coming home, and it gets sadder, and sadder, and sadder. And then here comes the next one, here comes the next one, but we gotta be quiet, we gotta see what's coming on. It's a dirty movie. Just slightly interested in what you want. And you recognize those people in the film. Look, you recognize them. Who is that? Oh God. It's your parents. Sleep now, Edith. You're slept and relax. Sleep now. Sleep now, relax. Give them all a round of applause. I'm gonna help them out a little bit here. We don't need years of therapy. Everybody on stage. Let's forget that last movie. We don't need therapy. Forget that last movie. It never happened. Now I'm gonna come by and touch a couple of you on the shoulder. And when I do, I'm only speaking to you. If I don't touch you on the shoulder, I am not speaking to you. Just allow yourself to relax and enjoy. Only the person I'm touching right now, your name is no longer whatever your name is. Your name is now E-I-E-I-O. Every time I ask you what your name is, you'll tell me it's E-I-E-I-O. If I get your name wrong, you get very upset, very mad, and angry, but you will not hit, cuss, spit, or throw a fit, but you will get very upset and let me know about it. Only the person I am touching right now, only the person I'm touching right now, you're the laughter police. This is not a funny show, it's a very serious show. People should not be laughing. So anytime you see somebody laughing, you're gonna tell them to shut up and be quiet, because this is serious. You won't get out of your chair, but you want them to take this seriously. How you doing here, bud? Doing good? Can you move your hand? Good. Close your eyes and relax. There you go, just like that. Only the person I'm touching right now, only the person I'm touching right now, you are a shoe thief. You have to steal other people's shoes, but you do it in a way that nobody sees you. Nobody knows, you can't get caught. And you hoard those shoes underneath your chair. Only the person I'm touching right now, you've lost your pet kitten. Your kitten's name is Fluffy. And the only way that you can find Fluffy is to call out in the highest pitch voice you can imagine. Try and find your lost cat. Everybody on stage. 1, 2, 3. Eyes open, seated upright. Okay, go ahead. Do your thing, girl. Nobody sees you. You look a little confused, but what's going on? Where's Bobby? Who's Bobby? Let's call out for Fluffy, see if we can find, Fluffy. Go ahead, call out, see if we can find him. You gotta be louder than that. Maybe Fluffy's in the back. Try it again, a little bit louder. Go ahead and hop up and just kind of look around the stage to see if you can find Fluffy. Keep calling out. Are you doing okay? You look a little irritated. Tell me about that.
He's kind of
the boss. Sounds pretty serious.
Yeah, and people are laughing.
They just keep laughing. Does that bother you?
It does. It hurts my feelings.
Well, hopefully he finds it. Let's keep hoping he finds it. How are you doing, buddy?
I'm good.
What's your name?
E-I-E-I-O.
It's good to meet you. I'm Jonathan. I just wanted to say hi. So your name is G.I. Joe, right?
No.
That's not my name.
What's your name?
It's E-I-E-I-O.
E-I-E-I-O. I'm bad with names, but I'm going to do my best to remember.
It's not even 2 seconds.
I'm really bad with names. Just 1 second. I'm going to try and help him find Fluffy. And I'll come back, okay? Alright?
No.
He's good. He can sit there for a little bit. Leave Fabio alone.
That's not my name.
I
told you 5 seconds ago, it's E-I-E-I-O.
E-I-E-I-O, right?
No!
E-I-E-I-O.
Yes.
Yes, okay. I'll do my best to remember. What's up, buddy? Where's the microphone again? Just keep looking. She's out there somewhere. You having a good time? Good. Have you met my buddy down there? His name is Tonto.
That's not my name!
I'm sorry, I apologize. What's your name again?
Tonto.
E-I-E-I-O. It's not that hard.
E-I-E-I-O.
Yeah.
I think being a hypnotist, I'd be able to remember that.
Yeah, probably.
Those don't be very good.
I guess not.
I'll come back. You don't think I'm very good? You look kind of disgusted. Yes. How you feeling?
Cat.
He needs to find this cat. No, he hasn't found him yet. But he's out there looking. I'm encouraging other people to help him. How's it feel when everybody's laughing?
Nothing's funny.
Nothing's funny. I think AEIO, you lost a cat too.
It's not my freaking name!
It's close though, right?
Yeah, I guess.
Let's see. Talk to my buddy. Alright, you said your name was
E-I-O.
Sleep all the way down, relax. There you go. Perfect. What do you got going on here?
Walking
around. What do you got going on under your chair?
The guy's under my chair.
The guy's under your chair? What about that behind your feet? Looks like you're hiding something back there.
My shoes are off.
Your shoes are off. You have 3 feet? Looks like there's 3 shoes down there.
You gave me your shoes.
That works. Fluffy's right here. She's right here in the chair. You can come grab her and pet her. We found Fluffy. Pick her up and have a seat and put her in your lap. Such a happy time. So joyous. All the way down, just let them relax, just let it all go, all the way down. Perfect. Round of applause if you guys are having a good time. How you doing, bud? Feel bad. You need to have a seat?
Yeah.
Go ahead and have a seat for me, buddy. Right behind you. And sit back and relax. Sit all the way down, relax. There you go. Just let it all go. So, Jordan is what they call an extreme somnambulist. And somnambulism is the deepest hypnosis that you can go into. He goes into somnambulism very quickly, very easily. And somnambulistic people just like to sleep. That's why they don't sleep. 15 minutes of hypnosis is like an hour of sleep, so everybody that's on stage is going to feel wonderful when they wake up. Everybody on stage, on the count of three, eyes open, be seated upright. You are jockeys in a horse race. The prize for first place is $50,000. You want so bad to win that $50,000 that you will do anything to win. Your chair is your horse. You cannot leave your chair. But you'll do anything to win. Everybody on stage. 1, 2, 3, eyes open, get on your horse and get ready to start the race. Looking a cow on a farm and milking a cow. those ladders and milk that cow. Milk that cow like you've never milked before. Milk with a fury. Absolutely great. Faster and faster. And now everybody on stage, you are human typewriters. Use your entire body. Act out being a human typewriter. Allow that to start now. Human typewriters. Use your legs, use your head, use your arms. Really get into it. Start typing. Typing. Everybody on stage, safely stand up. You're no longer typewriters. Safely stand up. And without hitting the people around you, you're washing machines. Everybody on stage, eyes open slightly, find your seat and safely have a seat. Do you believe in hypnosis?
No.
What's your name? How's everybody feel tonight? How does everybody feel?
Tired.
Are y'all having a good time?
Yeah.
Yeah, good. Looks like they're having a good time. Doing pretty good. She has her shoe on. Why does she have your shoe on? I don't know, do you?
She has the right shoe.
I don't know. Everybody on stage. Sleep now all the way down, loosen up and relax. Just let it all go. Perfect. Everybody on stage, you are all secret agents. And you're receiving a phone call on a shoe phone from the President of the United States. That shoe phone somewhere in the audience, you have to find it. On the count of three, you're gonna go and find that shoe phone. It's a very important call from the President. You have to take that phone call. One, two, three, eyes open. Find that phone call, find that shoe phone. Go answer it, be safe. Once you found the phone, make your way back up on stage with it. Everybody has their own phone. Talk to the President. He's got a special mission for you. Alright, everybody on stage, stand up. Everybody stand up. You are no longer secret agents, you are now fire marshals. And all of these people in the audience are in danger. They are in danger. Make sure and grab the shoe that wasn't found. Hang on. What I need you to do is put on your gas mask. That shoe in your hand, that's your gas mask. Tell everybody they need to get out. Tell them they need to get out. Everybody, see, the fire is out. Everybody's safe. You can take off your gas mask. Back on stage. Have a seat. Have a seat. Sleep all the way down there, limp and relax. Just let it all go. Give them a round of applause, everybody. Everybody on stage in just a moment. In just a moment, I'm going to show you guys a magic trick. Most amazing magic trick you've ever seen in your entire life. And everything that I say will happen will happen right in front of you guys. Everything I say will happen right in front of your eyes. Everybody on stage, one, two, three, eyes open, be seated upright. And I'm going to put the microphone down for a second. I need two hands for this.
All right. This is a belt, right? Okay, ordinary belt. I'm going to just wrap this belt up, okay? Just like this. Wrap up the belt. Now, in just a moment, I'm going to show you guys something amazing. Right in front of your eyes, I'm going to turn this belt into a snake. Concentrate on this, make sure.
It's gone. It's not coming back. You can have a seat up here.
I'm sweating so bad.
I promise it's not coming back. It's completely gone. Well, let's investigate that. Why is he wearing your other shoe? Why are you wearing her other shoe?
I'm sweating.
Where are your shoes?
I don't know. I don't remember what she's
wearing.
I don't know what she's wearing. You alright? I didn't mean to scare you guys. Sleep now all the way down there, sleep and relax. There you go. Just like that. Alright, so I like to help my volunteer just as much as I like to have fun. So everybody on stage, I want you to think of a fear that you have. Maybe snakes, maybe spiders, maybe clowns, maybe a fear of commitment. Think of a fear that you have. Picture, envision, think, imagine that fear. And I want you to imagine yourself pulling that fear out of your body and holding it in front of you. Picture it, imagine it, think it, feel it. Pull that fear out of your body and hold it right in front of you. Look at it, it has a size, a shape, a color. And as you're holding that fear in front of you, I just want you to throw it into the sky and get rid of it. And as you throw that fear into the sky, that fear lessens, becomes less and less. And you feel more confident, more comfortable, and more secure, and no longer scared or afraid. In fact, you feel wonderful and amazing. One, two, three, eyes open. Have a seat in your chair, feeling wonderful in every single way. Let's give everybody a round of applause. How you feeling, bud? You're lost. Do you believe hypnosis is real?
No.
What's your name?
I don't know.
We'll come back to that. Who up here on stage has a wallet? Who has a wallet on them? Nobody has a wallet on them? You? Open your wallet for me. You see? Appreciate it. That's the show. No, I'm just kidding. Take a look at that wallet for me. I want you to look at your name, read it to yourself. Look at it. Got it? See it? Close your wallet back up for me. What's your name, bud?
Justin.
Justin, good job. You sure? Sleep all the way down, relax. How you feeling over here all by yourself? Why are you in the corner? Are you in trouble? It's comfortable. Okay, well, we'll leave it comfortable then. All right, everybody on stage, picture, imagine, see, visualize. You're in your favorite dream car. You're in your favorite dream car. Whatever your dream car is, you're sitting behind the wheel right now. And up on the steering wheel, make sure you're buckled in for safety. There we go, buckle in for safety. And you're cruising down the highway. You got the top back with the windows open, and the wind is blowing through your hair. It feels wonderful. And you're going faster. Faster. And faster. Take a look at all those people to the left. And just give them a little wave. As you drive faster and faster, up, and you notice there's a cop behind you. He's pulling you over. He got you. Now, when the officer comes up to your window, you're going to give him the most ridiculous excuse that you can imagine for speeding that has absolutely nothing to do with you driving. Can you tell me why you were speeding?
Shopping?
You're buying a dress.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you tell me why you were speeding?
Pregnant.
Are you having your labor?
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna move you. I can get you more comfortable. Okay, sit up for me. And then sit all the way back in your chair. And just close your eyes and relax just like that. Chin down. Sleep, relax, just like that. Perfect. And stay right there. Where were you speaking? There's a cute boy in front of you. Can you tell me what he looks like?
Zac Efron.
Can you tell me why you were speaking? It slipped. Where were you speeding?
I want to go fast.
Yeah. You want to go fast?
Yeah.
Pretty good excuse. Only the person I'm touching right now, I'm gonna have you stand up and hop back in your seat, okay? A little more comfortable. There you go. Everybody on stage. Eyes open on three. 1, 2, 3. Eyes open on 3. Good. Sit upright. Feel wonderful. Now, I have something that I don't usually show everybody. It's called a sleep dart gun. Has anybody seen a sleep dart gun before? Show of hands. Anybody? You've seen a sleep dart gun? That's a real sinister look. Tell me about that sleep dart gun you saw.
I saw it and
they
shot it at him.
You shot and shot it at him and fell asleep? Well, I've got one that looks like my hand. Right here. I guess I must have went off a little early there. All right, so everybody can see my sleep dart gun, right? Everybody sees? I mean, sometimes it just goes off, on accident. I don't mean for it to, but are you okay? It doesn't hurt at all. Here. No, I didn't hit him in the face. It was in the shoulder. He didn't feel it. Oh,
You alright? I'm gonna hand this to you, okay? Miss your hand. There you go, you got it. It's loaded. I'm gonna take off your rib. Put it right here on your leg. So you don't feel anything. It's not scary, I promise. Now, all you have to do is just pull the trigger. All you have to do is just pull the trigger. I'm gonna help you. Relax. There you go. What is the weather down there? Everyone's okay. They're okay. What's the matter? So, while I'm sitting here next to you, I've become the most disgusting person you've ever seen in your life. I'm married and I'm hitting on you. No, come here, you can't get out of your seat. Come have a seat. You're stuck to your chair. Stuck. Come have a seat. Right here. There you go. Have a seat. How are you?
Please go.
Hi.
I'm married.
You're married too? Oh, you don't have to tell anybody.
I have a dog.
I thought we had a connection. When you came up here and volunteered, it was like a 10. You didn't feel it? You sure? I felt like a 9 or a 10. Solid. Solid 10.
Mm-hmm.
So I can't get a drink after this?
She's
on the range. I do have a cat. His name's Fluffy. You don't believe me? Well, here. You saw my sleep dart gun. I know it kind of upset you a little bit. Right. I don't have any more darts. All I have is a little bit of dust. Right. I saw my dust a little earlier. Just right here in my hand. Just... You're good? Give him a round of applause, guys. Everybody on stage, everybody on stage, eyes open, have a seat in your seat. Eyes open, have a seat in your chair. Eyes open, have a seat in your chair, everybody on stage. 1, 2, 3, eyes open, have a seat in your chair, feeling wonderful and comfortable. We're gonna start a band. We're gonna start a band. It's whatever kind of band you guys want it to be. Rock, pop, rap, even country. You can rap? You may be our lead singer. So everybody on stage, we're gonna start a band. It's whatever kind of band that you want. However, you can only play classical instruments. Harp, flute, trumpet, violin, harmonica. So pick your favorite instrument. Pick your favorite instrument, and on three, we're gonna begin to play a concert for all of these fine people in the audience. On three, 1, 2, 3, grab your instrument. Let's get ready to play. And start to play your instrument. There we go. Play your instrument. Looks like we got a harmonica, a harp, a couple violins, cello, guitar.
Ukulele.
Drums, clarinet, trumpet, harp. Harp. All the way down your legs. Violin, harp, and trumpet. Play your heart's desire. Just play it out. Play it out. There we go. And now we're going to have some vocals come up. Only the person I'm touching now, have it set up for me.
You are our lead singer. Stand up for me. You're our lead singer. Helen, whenever you sing, you've lost your voice but don't know it. Sing your heart out, okay? Fantastic, you did a good job. A little squeaky.
Yeah.
I thought it sounded great.
Have you guys seen my hair?
It's okay, you sounded great.
I knew it was awesome. That was how I did
complete it.
Let me see it for me.
Let me see. Move your hand for me. Let me see. Oh, my God. You're good. No, it was fantastic. Everybody on stage, remember how fantastic her singing was. It was so fabulous. It was the best thing you've ever heard. Give her a round of applause. It was so good. All right. Everybody on stage, on the count of three, you are all stars of Riverdance. Everybody know what Riverdance is?
I do.
Show of hands on stage, you know what Riverdance is? It's tap dancing. Tap dance to your heart's content on the count of three. However, when I say the word wide awake, you have absolutely no idea what's going on. You're completely lost and clueless. One, two, three, Riverdance. Now put tap dance for me. You gotta tap dance to your heart's content. Show everybody how good of a Riverdancer you are. There we go. You're doing fantastic. Doing good. Doing great. And wide awake. Put your ears down. One, two, three, dance your hearts out. Feeling fantastic, feeling great. Show everybody your moves and wide awake. What are you all doing? Where are your shoes? Everybody have a seat for me. Have a seat for me. Where are your shoes? It's the case of the missing shoes. What's your name, bud?
EIEIO.
We'll come back to that. How's everybody feeling tonight up on stage? Everybody on stage feeling good? You're giggly as nothing, man. Nothing. You look like you're having a good time. Is everybody in the audience having a good time? Good. What's going on? Is she moving? Twitching? Bothering you a little bit? Just let it all go. Perfect. Give them all a round of applause. Let them know. Only the person I'm touching now. Set up for me, sweetie. Set up for me. There we go. Just stay seated upright. Close your eyes and sleep all the way back. Just like that. Don't move. Good. Everybody on stage. The audience knows a secret of yours. It's something you don't want anybody to know. It's very personal. Don't tell me what it is. I already know. And the audience already knows. And you're going to look very distraught because the audience knows a very personal secret. One. Two, three, eyes open, be seated upright, feeling fantastic, wonderful in every single way. How you feeling?
Tired.
You look pretty tired. You just look distracted. What's going on?
I can't really see.
Can't really see. That's right, I remember. You look a little worried.
What's got you worried? You don't have to tell me, I already know. I already know your secret. You think? No, they already know too. Because you told them. No, you told them your secret. No, that's not bad at all. Yeah, it's okay. You ready to run? You're a little early. You okay? What are you going to do now? They all know. Absolutely everything. And you'll tell everybody how much fun you had. Other than the last two suggestions I just gave you, everything else about you has returned to normal. You have pushed your fear away, whatever your fear is. And you're not afraid to face it in the future. When you wake up here, you're going to feel refreshed, recharged, and ready to face the day, excited about what lies ahead, feeling wonderfully invigorated and motivated. Everybody on stage, on the count of five, eyes open, wide awake, and completely emerge from hypnosis, feeling better than you felt in a long time. One, two, three, four, five, eyes open and wide awake. Give them a round of applause, guys.